Protect your DNA. BioPQQ can promote formation of new mitochondria. Infowarsstore.com.
Take a look at how Hillary hide-and-seek Clinton responded to a Fox News reporter's request for her to finally take a question.
Yeah, just wait. Yeah, maybe when I finish talking to the people here. How's that? I might. I'll have to ponder it, but I will put it on my list for due consideration.
Good Lord, she is such a snarky witch. Can you imagine having to listen to her give a weekly address for 4 years? You think President Obama is bad with press access right now? Look at how Hillary has run her campaign. I can't imagine her taking any hard-hitting questions from the White House press corps if indeed she becomes the next president. Now, she did actually respond to reporters today once it was clear that reporters have stopped asking her what she had for lunch. Now they're finally going to start hitting her. So she, you know, she wanted to get out in front of it. So she did respond, take some questions from the press today, and she once again reiterated the fact that she really wants her emails to be made public. Gosh, if I really wanted my emails to be made public, maybe I shouldn't have sent them out printed in boxes so that the State Department would have to hire 12 full-time employees to sift through each and every page, some of which are double-sided. She might as well have just sent them out in Braille. Very clever, Mrs. Clinton.
Yesterday, we learned that the State Department plans to release Hillary Clinton's emails in January 2016. The proposal came Monday night in a document related to a FOIA lawsuit Vice News filed in January. They were seeking all of Clinton's emails. 12 state staffers have been assigned full-time to reviewing the Clinton emails, which were provided on paper by Clinton in banker's boxes. State says the scanning process took 5 weeks and was complicated by some of the printouts of Clinton emails being double-sided.
I have said repeatedly, I want those emails out. Nobody has a bigger interest in getting them released than I do.
State Department officials have cited the need to prioritize this Clinton email project because the Iowa caucuses are due to be held February 1st, 2016. That's just 2 weeks after their proposed release. How convenient. Well, today a federal judge rejected that plan, saying the state must propose a new schedule that involves disclosures of a batch of the emails every 60 days. Clinton's emails have been a subject of intense interest from a House committee investigating the Benghazi attacks. Some of the emails revealed that Clinton forwarded unsubstantiated intelligence on Libya to top officials at the State Department from Sidney Blumenthal. Blumenthal was not an employee of the State Department, rather a longtime family ally, an employee of the Clinton Foundation at the time. Blumenthal was working on business ventures in Libya that would have required State Department permits. The Benghazi committee hopes to ask Blumenthal who, if anyone, was paying him to prepare these memos for Mrs. Clinton and whether they were among his responsibilities at the Clinton Foundation. Investigators are also interested in whether the planned business venture in Libya posed any potential conflicts for Mr. Blumenthal or Mrs. Clinton. Proposed business partners sought meetings with Clinton aides in early 2012.
Andrew Malcolm at Investors Business Daily reports that this is our new normal. Obama tweets and Hillary Clinton chit-chats. Ramadi fell over the weekend to terrorist troops of ISIS, but thank goodness the weekend weather enabled President Obama to get in a game of golf. And then on Monday, quick, look over there. Obama debuted his very own Twitter page. Hillary Clinton, who is engulfed in scandal, hosted yet another small event in Iowa with media access so controlled, the Secret Service parked cars to prevent a clear TV viewing of her entering the building. And we're also getting reports that the Secret Service raced 95 miles per hour down the road to avoid any run-ins with the press. Now, Clinton had nothing to say about the ongoing collapse of the Iraqi army. Clinton, if you'll recall, was Secretary of State at the time when all U.S. troops left Iraq and a large power vacuum.
What difference at this point does it make?
From the water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself, our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States, well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape, but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new Infowars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfowarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.